Rock John, one of the old miners here at Calico Ghost Town. I'd like to welcome y'all aboard the Calico and Odessa Railroad. Please stay seated as we take a ride through old Calico. As we go around this first curve, notice the two miners' cabins built along the canyon wall. As cool as they appear, they were ideal for the hot summers and cold winters here in Calico. During the boom years, Calico's mining district boasted a population of nearly 5,000 people.
They would live
about 1,200 people actually lived in the town site of Calico. Today, the population is only 9.
The rails are.
Processing that silver would be well over $10 million. So do your math right, that would put you $4 million in the hole. Well, back to playing the lottery.
Sit down.
That's crazy.
Huh?
That's crazy.
He's crazy.
It's crazy.
Now, as we proceed,
you know what?
Look down into the gully to the left of the train.
They won't let you
the round rock structures you see are called bogans. They were built by the Indians who came to the capital area in search of the many colored clays from which they made their pottery, paints, and dyes.
Lucky, honey.
To the left of the engine is one of the original ore crushers. The miners would hitch a mule to that crossbar and ride that steel ball round and around to crush the ore before it was taken to the processing mill to nearby Daggett.
So much for that. Keep this camera open.
Drinking water for Calico in the early years had to be transported from the Mojave River, which ran above ground at that time. It sold for about 5 to 20 cents a gallon. Unfortunately, several children died in Calico due to a typhoid epidemic brought on by this bad water supply. Once a year.